Now, everything works in threes. When you do these exercises, three times on each side. The reason why it's in threes is just because it's symmetrical. The reason why I say it's symmetrical is because it matches the body itself. Okay, if you look at your finger, for example, you have three sections of your finger. If you look at your arm, you have a hand, a forearm, and an upper arm, three sections. You have a head, a torso, legs, three sections. So even your feet are divided into three. So this three is very important and probably why it's ingrained in so many cultures. So these exercises are performed three times each time. Now I'm going to go through the exercises, and as I do, I'm going to be working through it. I'll talk you through it as well. And as I talk you through it, okay, I want you to envision doing this exercise for yourself or just follow around along with it. Now as I move to this side, just use it as a mirror image if you're watching it on TV screen or a computer. Just do mirror image. Don't worry if I'm using my right hand or my left hand, because we're balancing it off. We've got it equally on both sides, so it'll work just as easily. Okay? On the spinal rotation, every time you exhale and clamp your feet, what I want you to do is, again, make sure that you roll that spine. That's important because as you're exhaling, you're bringing the energy up your back, okay, through the Sushumna, the Ida, and the Pingala. And as you do that, you want to release the pressure off each vertebrae as it extends. Now again, this isn't going to be an overnight process. This is something you're going to have to work on, as is lifting the toes. Now you're going to also notice for later on, when you're first starting the exercise, just worry about where your hands are going and which way your body is turned. Later on, once you get the spine opening, pay attention to your toes. Sometimes you'll see one toe come up on one side and it'll stay down on one side. Sometimes you'll see them both come up at the same time. Now it should be the big toe that comes up to put more weight on the outside aspect than the heel of the foot. But again, in the beginning, it's very difficult. In the beginning, I couldn't lift my big toe separately either. So lifting both, all your toes at once, that's fine. But somewhere along the way, as a detail, you're going to want to lift just one toe, okay? And it depends on the stretch, which toe you're going to lift to have more grounding on one side and also energy lifting on the other side. All right, so now as I go through this exercise, okay, I want you to watch all those details later as you develop, but watch the main exercise as it begins. Ba Duan Jin.